bit about your music, would you consider it like drill or just telling your life or like what?
So I just consider it like, you know, drill music, you know what I'm saying? Just some shit me and, you know, my label, me and my niggas came up with, you know. Like, we ain't start the shit, but that's the pattern, you know, the block where I'm from, you know, that's what I represent. I represent the streets. But it be real shit about my music, too, about myself. I talk about myself, too, so shit is down to everything, you know.
Right. What's the name of your label? I seen you, when I looked at your page and shit, I seen you got a label, like your own label, right?
Yeah, man, TSOB Records, Trap Squad, Oxbox Living. You know, Trap Squad, that's my group, that's my label. Oxbox, that's what I hit when I came to Fort Wayne, that's a whole different city. So, you know, we mobile, we back to back, you know, from Chicago to Fort Kane. So it's basically TSOB, you know what I'm saying, TSOB Records. So I got a couple artists and shit.
And we going nuts and shit. That's what's up, bro. So where you trying to take the rap thing? Like, you trying to start, like, your own label and just, like, do it from the bottom, like, the independent, bro? Or you trying to, like, fuck with the major record labels? Like, how you trying to do it?
I mean, right now, shit, I'm just trying to, you know, stay independent, you know, that way I can scrape up all my money, you know, pocket all my change. But, you know, I fuck with artists. I'll be doing features with, you know, artists like Mikey Dollaz, you know what I'm saying? My nigga Chase Band. You know, I did a lot of, you know, shit with a lot of artists, but I'm really trying to, you know, do this independent shit. That way I can give my money up, shit. If the deal come, it come. But, you know, now these niggas getting fucked out of deals, so shit, I wouldn't even want it.
Right. So, shit, bro, tell me a little bit about, like, growing up in Chicago, bro. Like, how was it, bro? Like, I know, like, a lot of y'all music, I've been listening to y'all music since day one, since Chief Keef, even Blue, for real. And it seemed like a lot of y'all music reflect y'all lifestyle, and a lot of people don't understand it. See, I'm from Baltimore, so I definitely understand it, but tell the world a little bit about that. Like, it's not promoting violence, you just telling your life story and stuff like that.
Oh, man, where I'm from, man, it's just crazy as fuck. It's like it ain't a normal city, you know. I've seen dead bodies, all type of shit, you know. It ain't no, you know, city you can just, you know, come outside and have a good time. Like, in some areas you can, but, well, I was raised on 105th, man. I just seen a lot of crazy shit. And, you know, that's one thing I just kept my head up. You know, I was just, you know, like, I ain't gonna let no nigga do me like that. You know, I gotta survive. So, you know, motherfucker been in a couple shootouts, all type of shit, you know, so I had relocated and shit just to, you know, boost my career and get some money, you know, and it's been working, but shit, I just left Chicago, you know, like a week ago, man, and that shit just, it's horrible. You know, I love my city, you know, I won't never turn my back, but shit, it's just sad to see, you know, everybody, you know, kids dying and shit, niggas. And this, you know, gang shit get to the head and killing kids and shit, you know, they putting, you know, motherfucking kids in danger, so.
Right.
You know, but it's crazy though, bro, like, the music I make is basically for a struggle. The same niggas that's still on that block to this day, you know, that's still out there, you know, they see exactly what I'm talking about, you know, I still go down there, visit my block and everything, you know.
Right. Why you think it is, bro, like, when people focus on music, you said a real small thing, like, you focusing on your craft, so you got away from all the negativity so you can do bigger things and get you and your people out. Why you think people get hot, like, dudes start getting millions of views, they start getting record labels looking at them, but they just stay in the streets, bro, and then, like you said, they end up getting killed or locked up? Why you think they just don't dip, bro? Like, why you think it's like that?
Some of the niggas, you know what I'm saying, that's all I understand, like, motherfuckers want to prove points, like, you know, the streets, like, they love the streets so much, but like motherfucker said, you know, the streets don't love you back, you know, I mean, it's all cool, cause some niggas, you know, I see that been on the block and got, you know, hella niggas that ain't gonna let them get touched type shit. But if you got a deal and shit, you know you hot out here, you know what I'm saying? You got kids, you got a family, you know, niggas be hating, you know, any moment you can get your life took. So why not, you know, go grab a house on the hill, you know what I'm saying? Come to the block when you can, you know, to see your people, you know, give back, you know, but just, you know, stand on the block and shit, that's dangerous as hotel, you know. Some motherfucker ain't gonna catch me locking like that. That's why I be here when I be mobile, you know. The motherfuckers I fuck with, they love that shit about me because they know I be mobile, so.
Right. Hell yeah, bro. Like, I think that's the smartest way to move. But, like, as far as, like, the music coming out your city, bro, like, I was talking to somebody, bro, and I feel like Chicago in the last, I want to say 5 years, bro, they had the spotlight, bro. And it could have been, like, so much bigger than what it is, you know. There's a lot of people I listen to from Chicago that some people don't even know because the music dope, you know what I mean? It's good music. Why you think the industry and people don't shine a light on y'all? I mean, other than Chief Keef, you know, a couple other artists. Why you think it's so many people in the city slept on? You think they scared of y'all? You think they feel like it's too much of a liability or something like that?
Man, this is why niggas feel like that, because, like, you gotta look at it, Brody. When motherfuckers, when Chief Keef first getting that shit, the people ain't really give a fuck about Chicago. It was niggas that was, you know, getting picked. You know, not occasionally, but seasonally, like Twista, you know, motherfuckers like that. You know, when Chief Keef hit the new millennium, the niggas looked, the outsiders looking like, damn, that's a Chicago boy doing that. Let's hurry up and pick them up before somebody else do. So when Chief got signed, there wasn't really no other way for, you know, none of the Chicago artists, because motherfuckers getting locked up, niggas killing each other. You know, niggas getting ready. I mean, niggas out here that got record deals and went on the block and tried to post on the corner and got killed the same day, you know. And, you know, that shit sad as hell. But Chief Keef, when they signed that nigga, bro, he got out of that shit. Like, they wanted to snatch that nigga up quick. Like, they ain't never hit no Chicago artist with that type of drill, that type of sound that can, you know, have motherfuckers off their feet type shit. That shit was selling records, so.
Right.
You know, that's why I said I'm just gonna do this shit independent. You know, hopefully motherfuckers stick their ear out and hear me, but, you know, I'm gonna still do it regardless of deals or not.
Right, right. That's what I'm saying, bro. Like, as far as this music game go, bro, I got a couple homies that fuck with it and stuff like that, bro. Like, you think it's better to go, me personally, I think it's better to go the independent route, because it just feel like you said, record labels look for a certain type person, but I feel like with all the social media and stuff now, you can do just as better independent as you can having a label or being with a label. How you feel about that? Like, far as, like, you know, like you said, the record labels, they digging people around. Some of these rappers don't got what people be thinking they have and all that.
Yeah, man, you got some super ass street niggas. You don't need no, you know, top flight ass video director like Benny Boom, a nigga like them, or, you know, motherfucking Joseph Scott, niggas who really they use the camera. You got street niggas out here that smoke Newports every day, you know, getting it out the mud, you know, that's good as fuck with that camera. Like, you think nigga damn that be on BET, like, damn, nigga, you good as fuck. Nobody don't recognize you. Niggas just stuck in the hood. That's why niggas charging like 500. 600, like, for a video and shit, cause, you know, niggas trying to come up the best way they can, you know. It's a lot of stuff, there's motherfuckers out here, you know, look at Chicago, you know, see good ass motherfuckers like Locka Films, you know, niggas like that, my niggas that, motherfuckers look at them, you know, see how good they is with that camera, you know, motherfuckers don't want a nigga to pass them. That's what I'm saying. That's why, like, niggas get on, they leave their mans, they don't want to see their man pass them, like, but, yeah, man,
motherfuckers
sleeping on us, though.
Right, right, right. Man, like, far as, like, collaborations or anything, would you only collaborate with, like, Chicago artists, out-of-state artists, or just anybody who hot?
Oh, man, you know what I'm saying, bro? I fuck with anybody that fuck with me, bro. If you fuck with me, you like my music, G, you need a feature, nigga, I'll charge you, bro. Holler at me, you know what I'm saying? Hit me in the DM, I fuck with you. Just don't come at me on the goofy shit or no stupid shit, right. You know? But other than that, hell yeah, bro, I'm gonna fuck with you. I ain't gonna be like that, you know? Nigga ain't just heartless. Motherfucker trying to get in that shit, too. Motherfucker trying to, you know, build a damn near a good name for himself so he can pay the way for me and my boys, because I got some talented ass niggas with me. No, we ain't just playing these niggas out here, just killing, freaking shit. You know, he like really, you know, getting money, bro. Like, niggas really trying to get on, you know what I'm saying? So.
Right. What you think the city need, man, for y'all to stick together, man? Like, for the violence to kind of slow down and for everybody just to focus on getting the bag and getting the check, man. Because like you said, there's a lot of talent up there. Hello? Can you hear me, bro?
Yeah, I can hear you now.
What you think the city need, bro, like far as like for everybody just to kind of fall back, bro, with all the shooting, bro, all the banging, and just focus on the money, because there's a lot of talent up there, like you said, and man, y'all could take off, y'all could be bigger than New York, for real, than they was back in the early 90s.
Real shit, to stop all that shit, it's gonna have to be more features. Niggas gonna have to reach out. Cause motherfuckers don't want to reach out. Niggas getting their feelings like this nigga do this song, they think he better than him. A motherfucker representing their block, he think, oh, he said fuck my block, see what his block. Reach out, do a feature. Show these motherfuckers it ain't no war between y'all, nigga. Like, we all in this shit too. Stop, you know, killing each other over this. You know, dumbass shit, you know. I ain't gonna say the music and the rap shit dumb as fuck, but when it come to your life, you know what I'm saying? Get off that shit, reach out, you know what I'm saying? Put your city on the map. Don't kill each other. Like, it's supposed to be us against the world. Like I said, you reach out to me, well, that shit, I fucks with you, you know?
Right.
Motherfuckers, everybody wanna be a rapper, but then when another nigga see another rapper raw as hell, they wanna get mad off some pussy ass shit, wanna murk them and shit. I wanna beef with this nigga cause he just hit 2,000 views in a day. Don't do that, don't hate, congratulate. That's a nigga for a feature and shit, you know what I'm saying? Maybe he'll put you on, shit. Right. That's just how that shit go, you know?
Right. Shit, bro, one more question, bro. We gonna end it on a positive note, bro. Like, for the youth out here, for the little youngins that wanna spit, that wanna rap, that wanna fuck with their lifestyle, any advice to them, or, you know, how to come up in this shit, you know, how to stay low-key and just make your music and get to the money?
Yeah, man, shit. First of all, stay in school, you know what I'm saying? If you wonder, you know what I'm saying, the age, your money, you know, stay in school, pursue that shit through school, don't drop out, you know, and watch who you fucked up with, watch who you fuck with, because, you know, motherfucker trying to throw you a deal or something, you can't let a motherfucker fuck you out of that, you know, if you go to school, you learn about that shit, you know, you'll hit that shit gold, you know, because I'm getting it out the mud, you know, so, just have faith in yourself, watch who you hang with, and, you know, keep that shit pushing, let that crowd hear that same song, that same dance, whatever you gonna do, just let them hear that shit over and over till they get it, you know, like, damn, bro, ass is blue, like.
Right. That's what's up, bro. Say, go ahead and get the people your Instagram, bro, Twitter, any sites, any features so they can get at you, somebody wanna holler at you or something, get a feature or something.
Yeah, bro, y'all already know, bro, it's TSOBL shit, so nigga, hit me up on Instagram, TSOBL_KingAWOL, nigga, hit me up on YouTube, TSOBL_AWOL, nigga, hit me up on Twitter, TSOBL_AWOL.